It's Movie Time is brought to you by the Gateway Film Center, 1550 North High Street, Columbus, Ohio. Further details and showtimes online at gatewayfilmcenter.com.
The award-winning It's Movie Time is produced by John DeSando. Listen to the shows and read reviews online at WCBE.org.
I'm John DeSando.
And I'm Kevin Carr.
And this is It's Movie Time. All right. Kevin, is there any truth to the fact that Sean Penn is really Liam Neeson?
Maybe if you washed him and then in warm water and you dried him too quickly. He's kind of a miniaturized version. I don't know. I mean, I think they're definitely trying to do that with him.
All right. The movie is The Gunman. And we're making this kind of joke about it because last week I dedicated a whole week to Liam Neeson.
Yes.
We looked at him in Cinema Classics and we looked at his run all night. And it's not difficult to infer that he would like, that Sean Penn would like to become as wealthy as Liam Neeson at this time of year.
I think that's what they're trying to do. The studio certainly was trying to do that. And I actually don't know if that was the purpose when they first started this. Because if you watch the movie, The Gunman, and you watch the trailer, they're very different movies.
Oh.
Because if you watch the trailer, it's Taken. It is absolutely them trying to make Taken again.
Okay.
And
Same director.
And that's what they're pushing.
As Neeson's Taken.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. And you've got an aging movie star,
right,
who gets really fit, and in the movie, in the trailer, it looks like they just kidnap his girlfriend and he goes on a butt-kicking rampage and goes after him, which is not actually necessarily what the movie's about. Would you agree?
Yeah, oh, definitely. And I would, judging from Sean Penn's comments outside of the film, it would appear, and it's not difficult to guess this, that he was interested in the multinational exploitation of resources in the Congo as a topic because he's an activist.
That's what he is. That's what charges him.
Right. And so him taking this role and perhaps seeing that it could be a very nice nest egg for him, I could kind of understand what he's doing it for. But in the film, Kev, I don't see much of this do good stuff.
Yeah. Yeah. I think they minimized the issues surrounding the Congo and the Africa issues, which I found most interesting.
Me too.
Just throwing him into Europe and running around Barcelona trying to kill people, that was less interesting.
Jason Bourne has done this stuff.
We've seen this many times before.
We've seen this.
And you're right. It totally looks like something that Sean Penn, the actor and the person, is interested in trying to take a politically motivated film. And there's nothing wrong with that.
No.
And I think that for the most part, they were still trying to do that because it's based on a book which I haven't read. But I imagine a lot of those themes are very prevalent in the book. And they wanted to make it an action film, but it's not. It takes, like, I looked at my watch. It takes a good hour before any real action set piece happens, which is okay. And I kind of liked that. I kind of liked it not being Taken.
Oh, Kevin, but I just couldn't stand the love triangle.
I don't even know if you can call it a love triangle.
Well, Javier Bardem.
There are a couple vertices floating around at one point, but it's pretty much just Sean Penn.
You know, but there is Bardem, to me, whom I love as an actor.
Oh, yeah.
I wasn't comfortable seeing him as a drunk who couldn't keep his eyes off of her. But then, of course, the director was cutting between his eyes and the young woman.
Of course.
Jasmine Trinca, a very nice-looking European woman playing Anna. But I thought they had devolved into something really silly.
Well, with her character, what's funny is this movie is that's where it's the most misogynistic and
good word.
Old school, I guess you could say. The she exists for no other reason than to motivate him to save her. No other reason. There is no, and I would have rather seen her either more developed or just dump her completely.
Right, right.
And just get on with the story because that's, I think, that was the biggest strike against it for me, was it was pointless. She was there. It was like you're seeing another damsel in distress from the 50s. And there's literally a point. It also just has this misogynistic view of women, of saying, of the ownership.
Yes.
Whereas, like, in Taken, Liam Neeson's going after his daughter. And, yeah, there can be some, you can feel some ownership of your kids.
Yeah,
absolutely.
Yeah. Would I be wrong, Kev, to make reference to, is it Blood Diamond?
Yeah, Blood Diamond, okay. The one with Leonardo DiCaprio.
Yeah, I'm only in the sense that there seemed to be more issue there than here.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm really with you. I was hoping for something serious about exploitation, and it wasn't.
Yeah.
And it does silly things like cuts to him a few years ahead of time and a few years in the future, and he's digging a hole for water.
He's building a well in the Congo instead of assassinating
this people. Good boy, right?
Yeah.
And yet another team is coming in to hit him.
Yeah.
Do we need to comment upon Sean Penn working out probably 6 hours a day for a year?
Yeah. I mean, he looks almost as good as I do without my shirt on.
He only gets with gigantic veins. And,
yeah.
I mean, we do have him... what is it? Surfboarding or whatever?
He's surfboarding. That was a little odd.
What do you think? I mean,
maybe they're trying to sell the Congo as the next surfing destination.
But more beefcake for him.
Yeah.
In other words, more that we talk about it, for me, the more the opportunity is lost, because Sean Penn is an Oscar-winning actor.
Yeah. He's a good actor.
I mean, if you saw him in Mystic River, he's very good. So he can do a great film.
Mm.
And for me, this has not been it. So tell me something really good, Kevin, here.
I will say this. I did like Sean Penn. I thought he was good in the movie. I'm not a big Sean Penn fan. I think he approaches everything in the Grumpy Gus way. Everything he does, he kind of looks like he's mad.
He does.
Except, whereas, like, why when he did Milk, that's why that was such a great performance in Milk.
Oh, yes.
Because you got out of Milk and you're like, I like this guy.
Yes.
I've never felt this way about Sean Penn. So I thought he did a good job, and I thought... And I liked the movie. I said, like you said, you take out the whole love interest, because there's even a point where she literally says, you saved my life, and so you marry somebody for that. I mean, it really just places women as property in there. But if you're to take that out, I actually liked the, I guess you can say complicated or convoluted storyline, whatever we want to do, but that's international politics. So I think that they play around with some really interesting stuff, and it's different than I expected. It just didn't feel like a knockoff on Taken, even though the marketers wanted you to think that.
And believe me, even though I'm down on it, and perhaps because I'm disappointed in Sean Penn, and because I wanted more of the heavy issues, but we do have a bit of a role by Ray Winston, who is playing a grizzled buddy.
He's awesome.
That would be the equivalent of the Nick Nolte cameo.
exactly. from Run All Night. Well, no, it's a great cast. That's the thing. And I think the cast is what raises it above being just, for me, a humdrum international thriller. And I'm not saying it's a great movie, but not just Sean Penn, but you also had Idris Elba in there. You had...
Who was seriously cut.
Oh, yeah. You can tell there's a lot more.
I mean, he's second billed.
Yeah.
And that guy is in there for a few minutes.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
But you also have Mark Rylance as the...
Yes. He's a TV guy.
Yeah. But he's great in that.
Yes, he is.
And we already talked about Javier Bardem, who, again, if you watch the trailers, it looks like he's this James Bond villain mastermind, and really, he's just a drunk. So it's so different. If you go see the trailer of this, don't go in expecting what you see in the trailer. Expect something different.
Okay. All right, so I have to give them credit.
Mm-hmm.
They're spying because of Liam Neeson's ideas here at this time of year. I mean, this is the worst time of year for movies.
Yeah.
It's got to be the worst.
Yeah.
And so making money inside of that, then it's pretty good thinking. Maybe we can get a piece of that pie.
Yeah.
So as you were saying, the producers want to put a film in here that they wouldn't ordinarily put into Oscar competition.
I think if they really wanted to do the Liam Neeson action movie template, they should have released it like January 9th.
Oh, good. Okay.
Because that's usually when Taken and
and
I remember Unknown and movies like The Gray, all that stuff opened early January.
Interesting. So you think they may have been a little bit late?
Because right now you're starting to get in sort of that pre-summer, you got stuff like Cinderella out there. You got
Insurgent.
Theater movies, yeah.
Right, yeah, you're getting...
Which is much more bubblegum pop action.
I know it is. Well, Kevin Carr, the film is The Gunman.
Yes.
It is truly Sean Penn's film, any way you look at it. Yeah. Kevin, what grade would you award?
Like I said, the cast helps raise it up. So it's not perfect, but I actually enjoyed it. I'm going to give it a B minus.
All right, okay. And I, you can tell from my depression over this film that I'm going to have to award it a D. But because of my esteem for my colleague here, I'm saying I'm probably being too harsh and not evaluating the film for itself, but all the notions that I bring in and what I wanted.
Yeah.
So I guess Kev's probably right. If you want to enjoy yourself and don't ask too much of the film, and if you still need some more of these old guys doing action stuff, then this film called The Gunman may be for you.
There you go.